Hello, people. My name is Gramtar Tikkavarim. I'm an environmentalist, an animal rights activist, an biocentrist, and a philosopher. I'm not a moderist or a pacifist. I'm a truth seeker. I did learn today that the Netherlands is actually quite, frankly, more myopic than I was thinking in my earlier video about calculating the amount of land that is needed to feed the population of the Dutch. And that I did calculate it, that it can only feed 2 million people on their own land. But that was without actually calculating the fact that the majority of the cattle, the cows and the sheep in the Netherlands are actually fed on grass. And why is it a problem? If you will probably ask. Now, according to statistics, actually, cows and other animals feed on grass takes around 3 times more land than the same cows fat on grains. This is partly because it takes far less problems to digest it, so the energy conversion is better with it. And also grass-fed animals take longer to grow than grain fed cows. One of the reasons the Netherlands do this is because they're actually spent around 1/4 of their land mass to raising grass for the feeding of those ruminants. You hear me good. Around 1 million hectares of land the Dutch people spent on raising grass for their cows. 70% of all those animals are fed on grass. Are you kidding me? You know, how much potatoes, how much rice, carrots, or tomatoes you can grow on so much amount of land, and you spend it on growing grass for animals you don't need to eat. The animals you are raising only for consumption of gluttonous behavior, the diet of the kings and queens of the medieval days. No. Using statistics used by the Council of Agriculture and Technology, Science and Technology, a group in the United States, I was involved in animal agriculture. You can feed on one acre of land 40,000 pounds of potatoes, 50,000 pounds of tomatoes, 30,000 pounds of carrots. That's what I did tell to me when and to Gary Rush when he did send him a message. I did tell him that the United States even can feed the whole world easy. Only the United States, that's a big country where you did make a spot on that you say American first, but can the Netherlands be number 2? You made fun of Donald Trump a bit. Where he did play his ass, nigga. Oh, N-word. This calculations shows us that the Netherlands can fit on that 1 million hectares of land, around 10 billion potatoes, 75 billion carats, and around 125 kilograms of tomatoes. About a lot of waste potential. Again, let me talk about greenhouse gas. Since we are already have a talk about land use. According to this study here, grass-fed cows produce around 4 times more greenhouse gas. 4 times than grain-fed cows. Both options are terrible for the environment, don't understand me wrong. But you don't need to eat animals. You can eat stuff like seitan. Seitan is a gluten product that has the same texture as beef. You use the same kind of spices, maybe different in the different amounts. And you can make the same texture of it, actually. You can make the mimic the taste of it very good with it. If you learn to put the combination of spices wearing the amounts. So, stop making excuses. Again. Seitan is also far less energy, take far less energy. 1 kilo wheat flour can give you around 300 to 400 grams of seitan. Wheat is around 300 gallons per kilo, according to the water footprint. So, in 1 pound of flesh of cow takes around, if you use low conservative estimates, 2,500 gallons of water. That's nearly 10,000 liters. For people that don't can understand gallons. The average Dutch citizen eat around between 75 and 80 kilograms of animal flesh. Of this, around 15 kilograms is ruminants. Ruminants, like cows and sheep. The majority of the cows on the planet eat grain-fed diets. So in my earlier calculations, I did calculate the Dutch consumption of grain-fed cows. But this is not the case, since the majority of the cows in the Netherlands eat grass. So my new calculations, using the average statistics of around 80 kilograms per pound to flesh of beef, of hamburger flesh, and skinning this up to around 4 times, since the grass feed cows produce around 4 times more CO2, I did come to the conclusion that this percent of the diet that takes around the equivalent of around 9,800 kilograms of carbon dioxide calculated from methane. I do it. Put this calculations to the 12,240 kilograms of carbon dioxide that I did use for the average consumption of the Dutch in my earlier statistics. That actually put it a little bit down into around 3 times, because I already did calculate the 1% of that, of course. So I did come then to the The equivalent of around 90,440 kilograms of carbon dioxide produced by the average Dutch consumer, their diet and their eating habits. If you want to see the drawings of the statistics that I just used to calculate this, I have them in the description below, so you know that I don't suck things out of my chin to fully comprehend the amount of land wasted on animal agriculture. We of course have also to go to the consumption habits of the Netherlands, and there seems to be a gross fetish for breastfeeding of cows. That's made for baby calves. And the things that drops out of the backside of a chicken. Those bird ass fetishists call ash. If you want to know more about this and why this is gross, you can check out my videos about them, also in the description and on the end screen. If the Dutch population started to be a plant-based country and disbanded their traditionals, actually this produce instead of cow cheese, plant-based cheeses, and did become truly a country that can or have the attention to feed the world, then I have to say you that the Netherlands can feed themselves on their land without exploiting and clever schemes with other countries. Themselves, they can feed themselves twice on their land that they use right now. So, is it time the Netherlands start become sustainable? Go vegan. Veganism is always the solution for the problems we are facing right now on the planet. And remember, there's nothing of a valid excuse to not being vegan in this damn time. Stop trying to find an argument. We vegans will always let you look ridiculous. Because we I know where you did come from. We promptly have heard them. So listen to what they say. Break your blinders off. And remember, when darkness and light become one, the reality splintered away and truth become visible.